What's with the new with method on JavaScript arrays? The array with method is new in ECMAScript 2023, also known as ES14, which is the standard for JavaScript. You can use the new array with method in JavaScript, TypeScript, and with any type of JavaScript framework or library, such as Angular, React, or Vue. Let's take a look. I'm in StackBlitz and created a new blank JavaScript project. Before jumping into the with method, how do you currently replace an element in an array? I'll paste in code to define a simple array of numbers and log the numbers to the console. Let's say we want to change the 23 here to another number. We do that by referencing the element using the bracket syntax, then assign it to a new value. Ages, bracket, and in the bracket, we define the index of the element we want to reference. JavaScript arrays are zero-based, so it's 0, 1, 2, 3. We assign that third element to 32 and log out the resulting array. Looking in the console, it worked. But do you see any issues with this code? The bracket syntax is mutable. It directly changes the original array. But since the ages variable references the address of the array, not the array itself, the variable isn't changed. So if you have a setter or a change detection or a state management library that's watching for changes to the ages variable, it may not recognize the value was changed. We often want to use patterns and practices that treat arrays as immutable. If you'd like more information on mutable versus immutable arrays, check out my prior video, Understanding Immutability in JavaScript. So, how do we update an element of an array in an immutable way? That's the purpose of the new array with method. The with method of an array works similar to the bracket syntax, but it returns a new array with a changed element. So it copies the original array and then replaces the element at the specified index in that copy. Let's comment out our original code and try the with method. I'll create a variable for the new array, then call ages.with. The first argument is the index of the element to replace. In our example, it's 3. The second argument is the replacement value. We want to replace the 23 with 32, so 32 goes here. Then let's log out the original array and the new array. We see in the console that the original array is unchanged, and the new array has our new value. Before we move on, recall from the beginning of this video, I mentioned that with is new in ES 2023. Depending on which version of JavaScript you are using, you may get a property with does not exist on type number array. To resolve this error, in your tsconfig.json file, set target to ESNext or to ES2023. The JavaScript template in StackBlitz did that for me, so I didn't have to make that change. If you are using TypeScript, TypeScript version 5.2 supports ES2023. If you're using Angular, ensure you're using Angular version 17 or higher. Angular 17 supports TypeScript 5.2. In my prior video, linked in the description, I demo how to set up Angular to use the new ES2023 features. Okay, going back to the index.js file, another feature of the new array with method is that this first argument could be a negative value. A negative value counts back from the end of the array. Let's change the 6 to a 66 by counting back from the end of the array. The last element is minus 1, so we want minus 2, and the new value is 66. Looking at the console, we see that the second to the last element is now 66. And one more cool feature of the with method is that it can be used in a chain of array methods. For example, we could chain the with a map, like this, .map. We call the array map method and add 1 to every array element. Looking at the console, the original array is still unchanged. The resulting array is a copy of the original with the second to the last element changed to 66, then one added to each of the elements. Slick! So, the ArrayWith method creates a new array from the original array and updates that copy, treating the original array as immutable. Use the with method instead of bracket syntax to modify array elements in an immutable way. This method is a great choice when working in applications that support immutable patterns, such as with state management libraries and functional programming techniques. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe.